If you offer a chocolate to a child which woke up early in the morning, it's called win-win situation. If you offer a chocolate to an employee who came to office on time, it's a win-lose situation. If you offer a chocolate to a girlfriend who came late on a date, it's a lose-win situation. And finally, if you offer a chocolate to a Toastmaster, I don't want to say, I leave it to the imagination of yours. Toastmaster of the day, fellow Toastmasters and dear guests, a very good evening to one and all present here. Today, I have come here to talk on a topic which we all use on a daily basis, which is negotiation skills. According to me, what is negotiation skills? The art of telling someone that I will win but you will lose in a very kind way is called as negotiation skills. The opposite of negotiation skills is called as dictation skills, which means the art of telling someone that I will win but you will lose in a crude way, which means that effectively the differentiation between negotiation and dictation is being kind or being crude. Let me share with you two examples in my life where I implemented the technique of negotiation skills. There are four techniques in negotiation skills: being accommodative, being competitive, being compromising, and number four, being collaborative. Instance number one. I had won an order of 50 vehicles to be delivered to Akshay Patra and ISKCON Foundation. They were crude negotiators, I will tell you. They had told me that I should reduce my price by 10% and deliver the vehicles before 1 month of the given time. For example, if I had offered them a price of 5 lakhs to be delivered by 60 days, they were asking me 4,50,000 to be delivered in 30 days. Now, which technique of negotiation should I use? If I use a compromising situation, my boss is going to kick me. If I use a competitive one, it's going to be a failure because NGOs always win. If I use an accommodative principle, it's not going to help me next time. So what I did was that I used the collaborative style of technique where I told them that I will give you 10% of the vehicles of 5 lakhs, which you will get it in 25 days. 20-25% of the vehicles in 4.9 lakhs, which you will get it in 45 days, and so on and so forth. That made me win the deal. My second exercise was on 30th of March 2019, where we had organized an area contest for international speech contest and table topics. The then area director had told me that, Vivek, you should have two objectives. Number one, the speech quality should be excellent. Number two, the food quality should be marvelous. Since I didn't have a control on my first one, the second one was quite interesting and was within my circle of influence. So I ordered a sumptuous meal for everyone who came for the meeting. The pro forma invoice which had come for this particular meeting was 350 rupees per plate. The then area director was shocked. He said, Vivek, my budget is just 150 rupees per plate. I just can't agree for 350 rupees. Then an idea struck me. Should I be competitive? Should I be collaborative? Should I compromise? Or should I be accommodative? That's where I learned a new negotiation technique, which is called as confusing. If you confuse people, then there is a chance that you win in negotiation. So what I did was that instead of organizing for one lunch, I organized for two breakfasts. One at 8 p.m. and the other at 1 p.m. 8 a.m. had poha and 1 p.m. had aloo paratha. With rupees 55 in my kitty for one breakfast, I had managed to add idlis also. So any contestant or a participant who came on that day would get poha with idli and alu paratha with idli. But the way I portrayed it to the audience and the area director was that I was the convener of the meeting. I welcomed all the guests and said, dear participants and guests, 30th of March is World Idli Day. So whatever you have today, Mahindra is going to give you idli free of cost. That created a lot of confusion for the area director and the caterer. But finally, everybody liked the way I had presented about the free idlis. The lesson what I learned in negotiating skills is number one. There are just two ways to do it. The first one is called as involve less number of people when you negotiate. Number two, when you have chosen one particular technique, be it collaborative or be it compromise, till the end of the negotiation, just use only that technique, else you will get confused. That's the lessons of negotiation skills for you. Toastmaster of the day. Thank you.